a moose, not a moose, when it's an elk. And that's just what Cai is going to be hunting this weekend in the Norwegian forests.
Hi, Cai, nice to meet you.
He has been invited by Thomas, a keen hunter, motorbike enthusiast, and one-man band. He's a bit eccentric, which is lucky because Cai's friend Trigger is no shrinking violet. Looks like our tame wild game cook has quite a weekend ahead of him. Let's start the hunt with fireworks. Why? Who knows, but there it is.
I was about to hit the deck. I thought we were being shot at. God, it's just gone 7 o'clock and they're putting fireworks in them on. These guys are bloody crazy.
While some hunters like to keep the noise to a minimum, in Norway they start the day with a bang.
Literally the whole of the forest floor is covered in blueberries. And they're all edible this time of year. It doesn't look like the frost has got to them. But they're pure, proper Norwegian wild blueberries and they're absolutely delicious.
Unfortunately, day one delivers a blank, although there's a brief sighting. Wolves are being blamed for a drop in numbers. Fireworks are not.
So we're here in Thomas's refrigeration unit, where I've got a calf that's been hanging for about 4 days now. So I'm going to take the shoulder off this calf. I'm going to make a fantastic curry this evening. I'm going to dice it up and make an Indonesian-style curry.
At the most, we shot 90 moose.
90 moose.
90 moose, and this quota this year is 15. And you see what's hanging here.
That's incredible. So
three calves.
So 90 moose down to 15, and you left the three calves here at the moment.
Right.
And that's because of the wolves and that's amazing. That's
amazing. But it was too much. I mean, it was too many.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was not good either because it destroys the forest.
It was too many moose, but now you got it down to number. So, but now they're getting a bit low.
The pendulum, you know.
Yeah. So you just want to rise up again.
Yeah, right.
And that's why when we're out there today, you're quite strict with managing. So no cows.
No cows.
No twin calves, so only there's one calf. Only the bulls that has got more than four or one.
Yes.
So they're quite strict when it comes down to shooting moose at the moment, and rightly so, to try and get the numbers back up to a sustainable level.
Cai is going to prepare dinner tonight, and it's going to be Indo-wegian fusion, or what you might call a culture clash, elk curry.
It's for the Indonesian curry. Got a couple of chilies, just roughly chop them, pop them in the food processor. About 250 grams here of shallots. I'm going to chuck them all in once I've peeled them. 4 to 5 cloves of garlic. And some ginger, about 3/4 teaspoon of turmeric. I've got some coriander seeds here, so I'll put about a teaspoon in a bit. You're gonna add brown sugar and lemongrass to it and kaffir leaves and lime still, so it's been roughly about 2 hours now. Everyone's enjoying themselves at the back, and it's just about ready. You can see the sauce is reduced, so a lot of the meat is exposed and coated by the sauce. So that's exactly what we want. I've thrown in a bit of extra coriander in there, some fresh coriander, but now that is ready.
Food is very much at the heart of all this hunting. An army marches on its stomach, and if Cai does shoot one of these animals, it needs an army to get it out.
So the time is now 7:30 in the morning, and we're just woken up to an absolutely stunning, beautiful Norwegian sunrise with pink skies and just amazing scenery. Thomas has got the working party ready. The rest of them are down there. So we've got everything that we need, the rifle and ammunition and food and coffee. And then we're about to set off. Hopefully today we get ourselves a moose.
Cai's patience pays off and he gets to witness his first elk within shooting range.
can't see him. He's in the tree though. Yeah.
The bull and calf, however, do not present a shot and they move off.
I can see his ass. I can see his antler. I couldn't see anything in the middle. No. That was incredible.
A few minutes later, a shot is heard. The bull has fallen to one of the other hunters.
You recognise it?
I waved at it. It's absolutely incredible. It's the first time I've seen a shot moose. And you were saying that you think this is going to be over 500 kilos in weight. That's amazing. I'm used to seeing red deer in England and fallow deer. This is like deer on steroids. And he came by us, and I could see his behind, and I could see his antler. I just couldn't see the middle. And then he just went, and then luckily one of these guys here down the line.
Yep.
But that's a group effort, so everyone here is part of a team. Yep. Everyone works together.
A lot of meals.
A lot of meals, yeah. It'll feed the 5,000.
So around 250 kilo carcass.
250 kilo carcass weight.
It's an impressive sight. The operation to extract an animal of this size brings the hunters together as a team. We often use the expression a team of guns for game shooting in the UK, but here the team is essential to get all this meat home. Cai is used to red and fallow deer, but this is something very different.
We've graddocked the beast on site and we've partly skinned it, and you can see how ginormous a moose actually is. I'm 5'10" and this is, well, if I put my hand up there, I still don't even reach the back end of it. So a truly magnificent, huge animal, something that I'm not used to seeing. It's awesome.
While stalking in the UK can be a solitary experience, the size of this beast brings a community together, and that is no bad thing.